3, Science Stigraphy and Urethrography, Part 1. Introduction. Conventional radiography of the urinary tract includes several diagnostic studies, cystogram, retrograde urethrogram, voiding cystourethrogram. All of these studies answer questions that are essential to urologic patient management. Voiding cystourethrogram, VCUG. The voiding cystourethrogram is a dynamic test used to define the anatomy and, in part, the function of the lower urinary tract. It is performed by placing a catheter through the urethra into the bladder, filling the bladder with contrast material and then taking x-rays while the patient voids. You can imagine how popular it is among children. Scout film. Several films are taken when performing a VCUG. The first image is a cub called the scout film. On this film one can evaluate the bones of the spine and pelvis, injury or congenital anomalies such as spina bifida, and the soft tissues, calcifications, foreign bodies, etc. Normal scout image. What gender? Scout film patients with urologic problems, urine infection or incontinence, may have a spinal abnormality that results in abnormal innervation of the bladder. Such anomalies are commonly associated with anomalies of the vertebral column. Let's look at some spines. Here is a spine from a normal cub or scout film. Notice that the posterior processes of all the vertebrae are intact. You can see the posterior process behind and below each vertebral body. Here is another scout film. Notice that the posterior processes are absent below L4. This patient has lower lumbar spina bifida. Read this scout film. The bones are normal. What about soft tissues, bowel, etc.? This child has significant constipation. Notice the variegated pattern of stool and gas in the colon. Read this scout film. What is the foreign body? Defining an unknown object. When you see something on an imaging study that you don't understand, it is helpful systematically to describe it. Shape, location, density. Give it a try with the object on that scout film. Defining an unknown object. Shape, it's long, thin and it curves. Shape of a catheter or tubing. Defining an unknown object. Location, is it in the child's body or external? Of course, a lateral view or an oblique view would answer that question, but what do you think? It is internal. Where does it course from into? It's seen in the region of the abdomen and the chest. One end is not seen on the film and the other is near a rib, but coursing from the abdomen to that point. Defining an unknown object. Density, it's relatively high density, at least as radio dense as bone. Whoever made that tubing probably wants it to show up on x-ray films because it is so dense. Look carefully at the spine compared to this normal scout film. The spine is not fully developed in the film on the right. Summary. Let's summarize what we know. Radiodense foreign body, probably a catheter or tubing, in the region of the chest and the abdomen. One end appears to be in the abdomen, and we don't see the other end. This child has spina bifida. It's a ventricular peritoneal shunt, used to drain cerebrospinal fluid in patients with hydrocephalus, common in children with spina bifida. Filling phase. After the scout film is taken, images are obtained while the bladder is being filled with liquid contrast. The bladder should appear smooth and regular and there should be no filling defects except the balloon of the urethral catheter. The edges of the bladder image should be smooth. Normal filling phase. Filling phase. This bladder is not smooth. This patient has an obstruction in the urethra. She has spina bifida. See that shunt tubing? Nerve damage from the spina bifida results in a physiologic obstruction to urine drainage through the urethra. Her bladder responded to the obstruction by detrusor muscle hypertrophy. This thickened muscle caused the irregular border of the bladder. Filling phase. The term we use to describe this irregularity is trabeculation. Note that the bladder isn't spherical. Some would describe this as a Christmas tree bladder. It's cone-shaped and it appears to have ornaments, actually small rounded verticillae, a result of high bladder pressures. Voiding phase. Images captured during voiding will demonstrate the urethra, strictures or obstruction, and the bladder, and they will document the presence or absence of vesical retro reflux, retrograde leakage of urine from the bladder up the ureters. Unless there is a voiding film, One cannot determine whether the patient has reflux because reflux may only occur with the pressure generated by voiding. Voiding phase. This film shows a normal male urethra. There is no obstruction. The variation seen in the diameter of the urethra is normal. Voiding phase. This film shows a boy with a congenital urethral obstruction. Notice that the bladder is trabeculated. In addition, reflux is present in both ureters. Post-void film. The post-void image may demonstrate reflux, contrast seen in the ureter or kidney, or extravasation of urine from the bladder or urethra, such as from a traumatic rupture. No reflux and no residual bladder urine is seen in this normal post-void film. Because of the anxiety caused by the catheter placement, it is not unusual for a child not to void completely. There are more accurate tests to determine whether a patient has a significant post-void residual. Ready to read some VGUGs? Case history: 6-year-old female with a history of at least 3 urine infections. Past history: negative family history. Mother and sister had urine infections and vesicoureteral reflux exam. Completely normal imaging. Pediatrician ordered ultrasound and VGUG. Ultrasound interpretation: left right size. NL equals 4 plus 6x. 6 centimeters. 7.7 normal. 8.6 normal. Shape normal. Normal parenchyma normal. Normal hydronephrosis. No. Normal renal bladder ultrasound. Here is her VCOG scout film. Bones. Normal soft tissues. Normal except for some constipation. Foreign bodies. No filling phase. Bladder shape. Smooth bladder contour. Smooth and regular reflux. No extravasation. No voiding phase reflux. No urethra. Normal extravasation. No post-void reflux. No bladder empty. Yes, extravasation. No. Normal VCOG case summary. This girl, like the majority of girls with urine infection, has a normal bladder, no reflux, and normal kidneys. Her urine infections are likely the result of ascent of bacteria up the urethra from the perineum. Do you feel cheated because we showed you a normal VCOG? Most VCOGs in children with urine infection are normal. Get used to it. The important thing is that you're learning to read the exams. Case history: 4-year-old female has had 2 febrile urine infections, fever to 104, nausea, flank pain and lethargy. Exam: lethargic white female. T equals 103.2, P equals 130, BP 78/60. Abdomen: soft but tender in left flank and bladder regions. U/A 100, RBCS, WBCS 50-100. Bacteria: many. Evaluation and management: full course of antibiotics to treat BL nephritis. Why did this girl have a urine infection? Renal and bladder ultrasound, normal. What other abnormalities could raise her risk of BL nephritis? Read this VCOG interpretations count. Bones. Normal soft tissues. Normal foreign bodies. What is that partially radioed as tubular structure seen in the region of the pelvis? It's the catheter used to fill the bladder with contrast. Filling phase, bladder shape. Normal bladder contour. Smooth reflux. Bilateral reflux extravasation. No voiding phase reflux. Bilateral reflux.